Morning, Amal. You are waiting off. Anthony, Nelvin, Sriram, children. So we were talking about sources. Okay. So from the British administrative records of British people, historians are getting a lot of information about history or the period we were under the Britishes. Okay, or about the colonial period, historians are getting valuable information from the records, reports, memos that being kept by the Britishes. So that Britishes, you know, children, they believed in the art of writing, and they have kept a record of each and every details. The information passing to from one department to another department, or from the government to the officials of that department. So with what all information related to the plan, a particular plan, policy, agreement, all they have written up clearly and they preserved it. Okay, and the specialized, and they attached record rooms attached to all important government institution. That means collectorate, Tahsildar's office, secretariat, everywhere they set up record rooms. And also specialized institutions like archives and museums. Okay, archives and museums are also established to preserve all these documents. And it was copied by all these records, reports, yes. Everything was copied by
calligraphers.
Okay, those who have good in beautiful handwriting. Then later, in the middle of the 19th century, printing press was invented. So they were started to print all these documents. Okay, and they preserved it well. So this provide a valuable source of information about colonial period. Okay, the incidents which was happened during this period, how the officials recorded all these events, all this was known from these records. Okay, then another important practice which the Britishers done was that survey. What do you mean by survey?
A check on something.
Yes, it was means assessing and recording the information related to an area or a particular place. Okay, so they have started to survey the entire country because they thought that a country could know effect, means to know better before. Okay, properly on it, then only they could administer it effectively. Okay, so they have started a set of surveys. Can you tell me the examples for such surveys?
Botanical surveys, archaeological surveys, anthropological surveys, forest surveys.
Yes. And in village areas, revenue surveys were held. Okay, to know about the topography. What do you mean by topography? About the landforms.
The physical structure.
Ah, yes. Then topography. Then soil quality, pattern, flora and fauna, plants, animals, the history of that particular area. Okay, to know about cropping. Yes, cropping pattern. So to know all about this, they have conducted a revenue survey. Okay, to know particular about that land or that area, they have conducted a revenue survey. And apart from this, they kept a record of the people who live in that area by taking census, every 10 years, the number of people, their age, their education, number of family members. Yes. Okay, so all these details, caste and all. So all these details was taken by conducting survey, and they kept a record of this all things. Okay, so these all are, this all provides a source of information, okay, about history or about the colonial period. And also, you know, they collected plant specimens. Okay, and they collected information regarding the particular plan, information about their uses, and also they draw. Yes.
Local artist picture of these specimens.
Okay. Yes, Shane. Gaudi.
Now, what is specimen?
That means some plants they collected for conducting scientific study. They have conducted a scientific study about the plants, their uses. Okay, and also they collected information regarding a particular plant, their uses, everything. Okay, about the name of the plant. There are different scientific names for the different plants. Have you studied it right?
Yes, custard apple plant.
Many apple. Scientific names are there for the plants. So they all collected information regarding the particular plants and also their uses. And also they asked a local artist to draw the
picture of the specimens.
Okay, yes, to draw the picture of these plant specimens. Okay, I have showed you an example for that about the custard apple plant. Yes. Good. Okay, so they have done so. Okay, so this all provides a lot of information about the past. Then, apart from these sources, that means apart from these records of the records by the Britishers, there are many other sources. Okay, were there. Now, we are going to discuss about the other source of information about the colonial period. I think you know about it. Can you tell me? Anyone? How do the historians are collecting information?
Architectural
manuscripts.
Yeah. Official records of the British.
Yes, official records of the British. This all provide a source, means many information, right? And you know, children, then many other sources also are there. So, children, mainly these all official records. Okay, children, so these all records, okay, these all records by the Britishers, they have explained only about what the officials thought or what they were interested or what these officials wished to preserve. Okay, do you understand, children, what I am talking about?
Yes, ma'am.
These official records of the Britishers, they have talked out, okay, or they have explained only the things what officials want to convey. They have recorded only the things related to their life or related to their activities, okay, and they do not tell about the tribal people or the village people, okay.
They depend on them.
Because these things they do not want to, means really want to convey. Okay, so they have preserved all these documents that was related with the activities of the officials, because this whole official all are the official records of the administration that we will talk after. See, children, apart from these official records, historians are getting information about the colonial period through the diaries of many people. Diaries, you know, children. The people are writing their daily activities. Okay, they are keeping a record of the things they were doing. So from all these, historians are connecting history. Okay.
The diary of a young girl.
Like autobiography.
Autobiography, That is the life experience. Diary means, you know, daily we were writing.
Yes, ma'am. The date and the time and what incidents happened.
Yeah.
Anne Frank.
Yes. And you know Anne Frank, about her life in Nazi camp, right?
Holocaust. Yes, related yes, to Holocaust. Holocaust.
Yes, yes. Okay, there, her family, they were hidden for, I think, for 3 years. They were hiding somewhere. After then, she moved to...
Only her father survived.
Yes, yes. Okay. So, means many diaries. Okay, that also, Anne Frank's diary also was a source of information about the Nazi period. Okay, a good example only. So, children...
Ma'am, I'm having that book now.
Is it?
I have read it.
Oh, very good. It was, you know, it was heart touching, right?
Yes, ma'am.
You know, children, next year you will study more about this Nazism and Hitler. So how people, the Jews, okay, only because they were Jews, the people in Germany, they suffered a lot.
And Anne Frank's book, it's mentioned about Jews, they are not allowed to go. After not some
even,
time.
Even they do not have right to leave in that country, you know, children.
They used to, they should take one badge and all. They cannot use the public transport and all.
Yes, yes. Mm-hmm. And you know, children, they were sent to the concentration camp. That means Holocaust concentration camps. There, they could see a fake bathroom. Okay, fake bathroom or fake shower head. Shower head. Through that shower head, poisonous gas will be emitted.
Poison chambers. No, yes. Gas chambers.
Gas chambers.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Then so this in the gas chambers, a fake shower head can be seen. And in that shower head, through that shower head,
poisonous gas will come and they will die.
Poisonous gas will be...
ma'am, another one is also there. This one is also related to Holocaust. It is fiction.
Yes, and you know, pajamas. Many people are killed within second. Within second, thousands of people were being killed.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. So the diaries of the people, that means that the diary or the daily events which was written by many people, that gives or that provides a source of, or that gives a lot of information about the past. So historians are, means they were connecting history by using the information written by many people. Okay, many people in their diaries. Then, accounts of pilgrims and travelers. Many travelers, scholars. What do you mean by pilgrims? Like saints, you know, those who wanted to preach their religion. The Malayalam term is Tirthadagar. Okay. So that pilgrims and travelers, they used to visit many countries, okay, to preach their religion or to visit many temples or somewhere. Okay. So the travelers, someone are explorers. Okay. So they were traveling throughout the world or throughout the country. So the accounts, the written in, details of these people, the pilgrims and travelers, they all kept as a record. Okay, to know about the history. Then autobiographies, as you said, some important personalities of their life experience, their travel.
Jawaharlal Nehru.
Yeah, Jawaharlal Nehru.
Okay. Ma'am,
Om Prakash.
Letters from a father to his daughter.
Yeah, we get information about the Dalit people in the time.
Ma'am, a set of letters written by Jawaharlal Nehru to Indira Gandhi.
Yes, yes. Letters. Yes, yes. Okay. So from all these sources, from the autobiographies of the important personalities, this all provides information of the things which was happened during that time. Okay. Then popular booklets that were sold in the local bazaar, local market. Okay. Some books, those which become popular among the people of that locality. Then during this time, I have told you many printing press, okay, was available, newspapers were published, and many issues were debated in the public. Okay, many issues or the things which was happened in the society, which was debated by the public in a market or somewhere. Then leaders and the reformers, Indian means we know that the Indian leaders, many of the Indian leaders who struggled to get independence. And what do you mean by reformer? Reformers.
A worker.
Reform. What do you mean by reform?
To make
reforms again.
To make changes. Okay, to reform the society.
Change society.
See, Rajaram Mohan Roy. Okay, Swami Vivekananda. Okay, because you know the society during, I mean, Indian society, they wanted to reform that society. And I think you have studied about, I think Nila Darpan, one story about the struggle of the indigo farmers.
Yes. No. Yes.
Yes, I
think in IMAX book, fifth standard.
Yes, fifth standard, you have studied about it. So many reformers, many reformers were there. They wanted to change the society. They wanted to spread their ideas through their booklets, journals, articles and all. So these all things, okay, means they have published many articles, journals, newspapers and all, that all provides information to the historians. Okay, then poets and novelists, many poets, then novelists, those who have written novel to inspire the people or to express their feelings against colonialism, okay, or against the tyranny of the Britishes. So these all information or all these records provides information to the historians to know about that period. Okay, that means diaries of the people, the common people, they have written their daily life experience, and many travelers, pilgrims, they visited India during this time and they have kept a record of their traveling. Okay, travelogue. Have you heard about travelogue?
Then yes.
Autobiographies of important personalities like Anne Frank. Okay, that means these all gives the particular information about that particular time. Okay, then popular booklets that were sold in the local markets, newspapers, leaders and reformers, they have wrote many articles, journals, etc. to express their ideas, and the poets and the novelists wrote to express their feeling. Okay, that means Nila Darpan is an example of the novel written, I forgot the name of that person, you know. So these all they have written to share their feelings, okay, about the misery of the indigo planters. Okay, so many such poems and novels were written by the leaders during that time to share feelings, and also they just tried to unite the Indian people against the British. So these all records provides valuable information to the historians to know about the things which was happened that time. Okay, is it clear, children?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, then we were moving to the last section. That means what do the records, why do the official records do not tell? I have told you, children, all these records mainly focused.
Ma'am, I think Nila Darpan was written by Dinabandhu Mitra.
Dinabandhu Mitra, yes, you are correct. Isa, Dinabandhu Mitra. Children, so mainly these old records, okay, they means about the official records. What mainly the officials thought about India, or what they wished to preserve, or what they were interested. Only that things they focus. So the life of the tribal people and the peasants. Tribals, you know?
Yes, people who live in forests.
Oh, yes. And the peasants, those were means farmers.
Farmers. Okay.
Yes, and all. So the life of these two section, or the ordinary people, the life of the ordinary man or ordinary people was even untold by the most of these records. Okay, so here you can see, children, here one man is, see, the poor people and children are sitting there in the market. So mainly the life of the tribal people or the ordinary people, how they lived, what are the customs and practices of these people. Okay, these all things was neglected or avoided by mainly from these old records. So we don't get much information about the life of the ordinary people or the tribal people or the poor peasants. Okay, so how history was experienced and lived ordinary people, the ordinary people's life was even not being discussed or not being recorded by most of these records. Okay. So children, this is all about from this chapter. I will just revise the points. If you have any doubt, we will clear it and we will clear it now. Okay.
Chapter finished?
Yes, chapter is finished. Okay. So children, I'll revise. Amal, listen to me. Are you here?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So children, history. What do you mean by history?
Things about finding
the study about the past.
Things about the past and also
things
how they have evolved.
Yes. Okay. So only means it's simply it's narrating. It's not simply narrating the things which was happening in the past. It also explains the changes. Okay. We know that as time goes, things are changing. So the earlier history was associated with the lifespan of a ruler or a king. Okay, when he died, when he married, means it was closely or connected with the many dates. Okay, but now in modern history, we are not connecting all these events. We are studying about the lifestyle of the people, how they improved their their irrigation, their production. Okay, we were talking about more in present history. Then also, when people are writing the history, they do give importance to the it depends on the perspective of each man who wrote history. So when the British historian, when they write history, they give importance to the rule of the Governor General, and which was started from
Baron Hastings to Lord Mountbatten.
So why we need to study or which dates are important? That means when we see that particular thing, okay, or when we need to focus some particular thing, we have to note it as important. Okay, so to give or to study history better, we are dividing into different periods or chapters. Okay, that means we need to focus some particular things which was happened during a particular time. Okay, so we are dividing to focus that particular events. We are dividing history into chapters or periods. Okay, so one such periodization was done by James Hill. He divided Indian history as
Two periods: Hindu, Muslim, and British.
What was the name of the book?
The History of,
British India.
You know, children, why he divided? He mainly focused the religion of the rulers, because before Britishers, many Hindu, Muslim, despots means autocrat, one man rule. A king is ruling. His powers were not limited. Okay, so before, when the Britishers came, many Hindu Muslim despot ruled the country. And what was the belief?
India could not survive without the British.
Without the help of the Britishers. Okay, so they wanted to conquer India. They wanted to hold their power, administrative power over India. Then, For that, Robert Clive asked James Fennell to produce the map of India.
Of Hindustan.
Okay. Then we are not blindly believing, or we cannot divide Indian history as what James Mill divided, because we cannot divide history in the through the name of the religion of the rulers. So many historians divided Indian history as
ancient medieval and modern.
But this periodization had also its drawbacks, because this is a periodization which was borrowed from West. Okay, but for European countries, it was okay. There was modernity in each field of means in science, reason, democracy, they have equal right. But we could not say it as about India, because this time we were under the
under the British.
Yes, British. So here I have told you, children. Here the rebellion, that means 1857, our soldiers revolted against the Britishers. Okay, it means many laws that was passed by the Britishers that affected their sentiments. Against that, they were suppressed. They were, their working condition, their salary, it was not satisfactory. So they revolted. But what was the caption given by the Britishers? Mutinous sepoys share the loot. That means they presented the Britishers, sorry, the Indians as greedy. Okay, they have looted everything. Okay, that was the concept of the Britishers. They do not treat Indians as equal. Okay, so we could not say India means the modern period. We could not refer it as modern, because we were under the colonial rule. There was no equality. There was no modern thinking or thought about any sphere. Okay, then and these all the features of the colonial period. They collected taxes. They brought goods at cheap rate. So the Indians, they do not have any freedom. There was no equality. The life of the people was hard and miserable. So there was no modernity. It was just being oppressed by the Britishers. So during this time, that means the Britishers, they had a wide market all over the world. Here we could see the advertisement by of Lipton Tea. Indian Palace in the background. Indian Palace is shown, and it was the third son of Prince Arthur. Okay, he was what was the title given to him, children?
Duke of Connaught.
Then about what is colonial? What is colonial? So that is important.
When a country is under the control of another country.
Okay, so there are many changes are happening. So that refers to as colonialization. Then about the sources, we have discussed about the administrative records, about surveys, about census. Okay, and also about other surveys which was conducted by the Britishers. This all provides information about the things under the Britishers, when we were under the Britishers. Then apart from that, diaries of the people, travelogues, okay, then autobiography, many books which are sold in the market, newspapers, the records, means the reformers, leaders, their ideas, their articles, this all provides information about the past. But what do the records do not tell? It was mainly about the life of the
ordinary people.
That means the ordinary people life was being untold by the these records. We don't get much information about the life of the ordinary people, how they lived, about their customs, about their practices, about the society. Okay, so these informations are being untold by all these records. Okay.
Sources.
Yes. So children, if you just read the textbook today, and if you have any doubt, we will discuss it in the next class. And